For me coming out here, I mean, I was a loved one. I wasn't a returning player, but I almost have that returning player experience because I've played in a similar show. I've played a game just like this, and I won Big Brother. Coming out here, I fully expected to win Survivor. Like, I expected to win. And, you know, clearly things didn't go my way, and I was let down. But at the end of the day, I mean, the entire experience, or the Survivor experience as a whole, I mean, it's one of a kind. And it's surreal in a way, because when you're out there on the island, you know, and you're hungry and you're fighting for your life in the game, you begin to appreciate other things. You look at your life back home and think, man, you know what? I have it good back home. I'm lucky. And that's one thing that I'm really going to be able to hold on to, that I'm going to look back and say, hey, Survivor showed me kind of how good I have it outside of the game. And that's probably the biggest takeaway for me. I mean, clearly, I wanted to take away $1 million, and that was my goal coming out here. Like, I wanted to win. I thought I was going to win. But then when I didn't, you know, I kind of took a step back and said, you know what? Maybe somebody else needs the money a little more than I do. And really, what can I take from this experience that's gonna make me a better person, like, moving forward? I was happy to see the Redemption Island twist because, in a way, it's a second chance out here. You know, I thought coming in that I was gonna be pretty competitive and good at these challenges. And I was like, hey, if I get voted out, cool, I'll go to Redemption and I'll be able to maybe win my way out. So it's almost like, you know, an insurance policy. At the end of the day, you get voted out, you're not out of the game yet. You can fight your way back in. So in that sense, some of the moves and some of the strategy, you could almost play a little more aggressive, because if you make a mistake, you're not dead. You know, and some people, and one other thing you had to consider is, hey, if you send somebody to Redemption, they might come back in the game. So you had to be kind of careful who you targeted, because there was a good chance they were coming back. So, there, I mean, the Redemption Island twist, it creates a whole new dynamic, especially when you also have the option to switch with your loved one. Like, that's a whole different can of worms. But when Kat was in there, I mean, I considered, like, I almost switched with her. And, I didn't. Maybe I should have if things would have been differently. Who knows? 36 days in the game is a long time. And when you spend 36 days in maybe the most, or one of the most stressful environments you can imagine, you put things in perspective. There's things you take for granted, like Kat and I. We have a great relationship at home, but out here, it's like magnified. It's like, hey, you know what? Our relationship is really good. I really, really care about this girl. And maybe, you know, even maybe it's time to, like, take it to the next step when I get back home. And that's something I would never say ever at home. It's like, you know what? Let's take things slow. We don't have to worry about things. But out here, you realize, you know, how important those little things are and how important the relationships you have back home, how important they really are. So Kat and I, we have a good relationship as it is. I mean, we get along great. Of course, we have our, you know, our cat fights and whatever. But we just have fun together. And coming out here, we thought, okay, this is gonna be great. We'll be able to come out, have fun together, compete, and kind of test our relationship a little bit. And being out here for 36 days, you know, 20 of the days Kat was here, but she wasn't with me. Like, we were separated. But even though we were separated, our relationship is going to be way stronger. Like, this experience, I can tell you right now, is really going to solidify what Kat and I have together. Because, again, being out here, you realize how special things are. And just sitting on the beach, I realized how special Kat is. I mean, she's funny, she's pretty, she's gorgeous, she's got a lot going on. She's dingy. Like, we all know she's dingy, and she has her moments where it's like, Kat, what do you think? Like, what is going on in that brain of yours? Because I don't get it. Like, but those little things, I mean, she's special. She's one of a kind. And that's something, like, I appreciated it before, but now I look at it and it's like, man, she's special. Like, she might be the one. Like, you know what I mean? I really, you know, our relationship is going to be way stronger. Being out here, it magnifies everything that I love about Kat. And, you know, I can't wait to see her again. for me, the social game kind of comes easy. Like, it really does. I'm able to relate to people. I'm able to get people to trust me. I've played a social game already before, and I did well. Forming alliances, creating bonds, building trust, that's the easier part for me. And, you know, maneuvering within the social aspect of the game, I mean, it's tough. When you get late, you know, there's going to be people lying to you, and you have to make decisions. But I feel like that's a tough part of the game. But for some people struggle more with that part of the game than I do. Like Monica, for example, you know, she's made it into the final three, but that's not her strong part of the game. Like, she kind of was carried in or whatever. But really, the surviving aspect is tough. Not eating. I mean, I lost 25 pounds. 25 pounds in 36 days, that's a lot of weight. And just not eating and being hungry makes you grouchy. It does. And kind of foraging for food and trying to fish and then going to a challenge and going through these long, tough days without food and, you know, being dehydrated. That's probably the toughest part, or one of the toughest parts. But that's tough in its own. And then you throw in the social part, which it's not easy by any means. And then you also throw in the physical aspect of challenges. And you have to mix the three together to really kind of figure out, God, this game is, it's not easy.